As a reporter, I've covered too many stories to count. A lot of them are memorable, but there's one that people ask me about more than any other. Nick Vujicic. He's a remarkable man from Brisbane. I first met more than a decade ago. Excuse the pun, but Nick was dealt the toughest of hands. He was born without them. No arms or legs either. But has it stopped him? No way. As you'll see, his life just gets more and more wonderful. Nick Vujicic was born 36 years ago with no arms, no legs, but a great sense of humour. When you go swimming, you call yourself
Bob, because I just Bob.
And I say no arms, no legs.
No worries.
Mate.
Mate. Yep. It's all good.
You're a charismatic fella.
Do you see my arms flying everywhere when I talk?
Humour underpins everything though, doesn't
yes.
it? It really does.
It does.
Nick had once feared a lonely, tormented life.
Okay, Kirstie, jump!
But this remarkable man of faith has worked hard to create his own miracle.
I got you!
Oh, you got me!
He's now a married man and a father.
Good boy. I love you.
I love you.
So much has changed in the 11 years I've known him. When you first meet Nick, you can be forgiven for feeling a bit awkward.
Jeez, how heavy are you?
I don't know, but
it's a bit bad. What, how
heavy? 34.
But it takes only a moment for him to embrace you and put you at ease.
I love you, Peter.
Back then, a 25-year-old Nick told me 10. Of his dreams.
Nice, mate. Thank you very much.
Kids one day?
Absolutely. Yeah, medically, I can have kids. Well, I'm not going to be pregnant, but yeah. But, yeah, I see kids definitely in my life. Yeah, I can't wait to be a father.
How life has changed. Today, Nick lives in a beautiful house near Malibu, California.
Hey, Nick.
With his wife, Kanaya, and their four children.
Wonderful to see you. Welcome back.
Thank you, mate. The house looks terrific. You look terrific.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
2008.
I think we're getting a bit out of control here.
Yeah. 2012. Yep. And here we are again.
Amazing.
And people to meet.
Absolutely. Gorgeous people.
Today, Nick is the father of two boys and identical twin girls.
Come in, Peter.
Thank you, Nick.
Hey,
who's
guys.
Huh?
Hello.
Hello.
So, Peter, this is everyone. Dayan Kyoshi, come say hi to Peter. Come give him a high five, give him a hug.
How are you?
My name's Kyoshi and his name is Dan, right there.
You are beautiful. Kane.
Hi.
Beautiful.
How are you?
So good to see you.
So good to see you again.
You look stunning and all these beautiful children. Who are these little ones?
So this is Olivia.
Hello,
and
Olivia.
And that's Ellie. And they're identical twins.
And you both look exactly
like
your dadda.
Oh, yeah.
My goodness me.
Nick and Kanaya married in 2012 and wasted little time in creating their dream of a family. His condition, the extremely rare tetra-amelia syndrome, isn't genetic and so wasn't passed on to their four children.
Can you help me up?
That itself was a huge relief in a life full of challenges.
Well, we don't want to come across to people to say that, you know, we don't still face challenges and that we, you know, still have ups and downs. I remember one of the questions you gave us last time was, what do you do if Nick says a crossword or something like that? You know, do you take his meal away from you? And Kanaya's reply at that time was, well, we haven't had an argument yet, yeah. So...
Have you had one now?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we've had.
Quite a few. I got the plate, baby, so you can do the bottom.
Nick, you see what Kanaya does for the family. All the heavy lifting. Yes, she has help. But when it all said and done, it comes down to her. Has that weighed on you at times, the work that she does for your family?
Especially when Dayan was a newborn, I really felt the pressure and stress like I'd never actually imagined. my heart, it's hard to describe in words, but when I see Dayan crying and I can't help her and I can't help him, or I see Kiyoshi on an edge and about to fall and I can't do a thing, it really brought me to a level of stress I never imagined on that. And even to the point where I said, babe, I don't think I can. I mean, she's doing all the work and I'm like, I'm saying, I can't do any more children. And she just came back and said, no, I don't think I'm done yet. This is it. This is what I signed up for.
When Nick was born back in 1982 in Brisbane, his parents went into what he describes as a period of darkness.
There was a morning that my mum and dad went through and having the dreams of what our child could be and who is he going to be and what is he going to do, and seeing those dreams go out the door, seeing that I have no arms and legs, I can't imagine what they felt.
But after a while, they realised if Nick was going to survive, he had to learn how to cope. And so he did.
I think it was the way that I was raised up as a child. My mum and dad said, we actually don't know what you can do, so go try. And that was the mentality that I had. And no one likes failing.
So Nick had to throw himself head first into the smallest of daily obstacles most of us take for granted.
Hey, Kiyoshi, let's go.
What he can do with his body is truly remarkable.
High five.
Whether it's swimming, kicking a soccer ball,
good,
or sending a text message, Nick just gets on with it. But it's when he was a 17-year-old at high school that a cleaner told him something that would one day transform his life.
This all began with like the school cleaner saying, I think you can talk to people, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. It started with the janitor saying, you're going to be a speaker. And I said, no, I'm not. You're crazy.
Welcome, Nick Wojciech.
The number of people listening to Nick started with a group of six and then grew to hundreds, to thousands, and then awesome, to hundreds of thousands.
Right now, if you know you need to make your life right with God, stand and come on down the front.
From presidents to prisoners, Nick has spoken to them all. He's both an evangelical pastor and a motivational speaker.
It's been now 70 countries. I've been to China, for instance, up to 37 times.
Biggest audience?
800,000 people face to face.
Today, Nick has returned to his hometown, Brisbane.
Good to see you.
And he's talking to teenage school kids about something extremely personal to him, school bullying. When Nick was 10, he was bullied so badly, he tried to end his life.
I think teenagers at this time are very much looking to other people for direction or something or someone to validate, who am I? What am I going to do in life and who am I going to be? What's my value? What's my place in this world? And because I was so anxious and hungry to look for that truth early on in my depression, in my attempted suicide, I want them to know early on that you'll overcome anything and to not listen to the world when the world says you're not good enough. Get a second opinion.
It's a big honour to have him here at our school, so can we give him the biggest, warmest welcome that State I can well offer? Let's give it up for him.
Hello, Brisbane State. Hi, how are you? Good, good, good. So what is it? What are we looking for in life? For me, I wanted arms and legs, and I thought, man, if I just had arms and legs, then everything's gonna be okay.
This packed auditorium at Brisbane State High School is transfixed on Nick and his message.
Do you know that when I started my speaking career, I actually called 52 schools in Southeast Queensland and said, hi, my name is Nick Vujicic and I'm a speaker. Can I come and speak at your school? And guess what they said? No, thank you. They hung up the phone. You see my foot? When you go through your ups and downs, you gotta take one step at a time. one step at a time. One step at a time.
Do you reckon you're brave, Nick?
I'd have to say I've got a good level of courage, but for me, courage is when you've overcome your fear, but that doesn't mean you're not afraid.
I reckon you're very brave.
Thanks, Peter.
I reckon everyone would think you're very brave. You expose yourself in such a raw way, and that takes guts and courage. And I'm sure Kanaye would agree with that.
Absolutely.
Very brave.
Absolutely.
We're going to the beach.
We're going to the beach.
We're going to the water. Just splash, splash, splash.
When it all comes down to it, Nick Vujicic has simply led his life by example. When you're walking through the hood. For this man and his remarkable wife, a handicap is only as big as you make it. Now, with the backing of a loving family, Nick has taken himself to the edge and not only survived, but prospered.
Thank you. Give me a kiss. Thank you.
Nick, over 10 years ago, we sat on the beach and I asked you what your dreams were, and you said to fall in love and to have a family. Did you picture it like this?
Well, I did fall in love, and we are in love, and this is the most incredible life that we could ever... Well, even it's even beyond our dreams.
How about you? Did you believe that this would come back and visit you like this?
No. No. No way. This is beyond anything I could have ever imagined, but like Nick said, what a beautiful surprise, and I feel like I'm living the dream that I couldn't even dream.
What a life. I'll come back for their weddings.
You'll get an invite.
Thank you. Gotta keep this
going. Gotta keep the faith. Hey, Peter, can you give me a lift? Can't feel my legs, man.
You and your sense of humour, my friend.
Oh, one, two, three.
Oh, good job.
You comfy?
Yeah. Feel good.
I've had a great day, mate.
Good to see you. Thanks for coming. I'm so glad you saw my family.
Oh, they're beautiful. And you're an inspiration, my friend.
Oh, thank you.
I've just loved it, every minute of it.
Thanks, brother.
Good to see you.
Cheers, give me a hug.
See you soon.
Yeah.